Yeah, we struggled a little bit on terms of development. I think everyone knew this. Didn't have as much development and as much money as all the other chassis. So, and especially in the category like Moto2, where it's so close and every little helps. But in terms of, I wouldn't say we had a bad year, because when we look at in terms of Sandro Cortese, where I was only like 3 or 4 points behind him at the end of the year, and he was the world championship in Moto3 in 2012. In that term, we didn't have a bad year, but as a rider, I wasn't happy with the positions we was finishing in, and it was a hard year. It was a hard year, and I'm just happy to be back with back on machinery, where I know I can go out there and do well. Yeah, it's not been too bad. I thought it was going to be a little bit harder with my size and getting back onto a smaller bike, but it's the same with anything. Once we've done a few sessions back on the Moto3, your body sort of adapts to it again. So it's like being back at home. Yeah, definitely. At first, it was a lot slower, and the main thing. The main thing which was different was the weight of the bike. Where like going to the corners, there was no weight to it, and it would just drop into the corners. So that was something which I had to get used to again. Like sometimes I turn in too early because I was used to Moto2, where you had to sort of like try and get the bike in early because where the bike was so heavy. But yeah, other than that, it didn't take much to get back used to Moto3 again. I guess there will be some pressure on me. Having quite a bit of experience now, where I've been in a 125, Moto3 in 2012, Moto2, and back to Moto3 again. With that experience, I think there'll be a lot of pressure, especially from myself, to do well this year. We've got the machinery, we've got the team, and I've got the group around me to definitely fight for the title this year. Yeah, it's well known. It's got a lot of experience. The team is one of the best teams in Moto3. It's won world championships with Marc Marquez, Sandro Cortese, and I'm definitely in the right. I've definitely got the right package this year to have a good year. Yeah, that's it. A couple of weeks ago, we done a 4-day test in Almeria, and then a 1-day break, then 3-day test in Valencia. And more or less every day we add new parts from Husqvarna to try some new parts. So yeah, this is also good. We get the new parts first, and sometimes it's not always a good thing to have new parts because they're not always as good as the old parts, but that's part of testing. That's what we're here for, preparing ourselves ready for Qatar. I don't know. I don't know if they was expecting me to be immediately at the front or in the top three. It's because I think also being 2012, where I had such a good last part of the year, where I won 2 races, I think some people will be expecting me, and this is where some of the part of the pressure will come from, because I've done it before, they'll be expecting me to do it again. Yeah, that's it. The main aim is to win the championship, but before that we just need to be as consistent as possible. Exactly like Maverick Vinales last year, I think he only won 2 races, but he won the world championship. So that's the main important thing, is to be as consistent as possible, have some good results at the beginning of the year. And if we can go to Qatar and I'm on the podium and then continue out through that throughout the year, then I'll be really happy. Looking from the results of these last couple of tests, I think there's going to be about 4 other riders which are looking fast, which is my teammate Jack Miller, Antonelli, Romano Fanati, looking like Isaac Vinales could be there, but he was sometimes fast last year for 1 lap. So the main thing here we're working on is consistency, with not just doing 1 fast lap. We're looking to do quite a few fast laps. Yeah, that's it. It's always good to have someone which speaks your language in your team. Being with a Finnish team, but with all like Spanish mechanics, is sometimes get a bit tiring just in the Spanish all the time. But yeah, it was good to have an English-speaking teammate. The plan will be, if I have a good year this year, we'll hopefully open doors again for Moto2 with a good team and with a good chassis. And that's the my goal, is to have a very strong year this year and go back to Moto2 next year.